Well, hello. How are you? It's lovely to see you again. I'm glad you've joined me to read this story because this is the third book in a series that I've been reading you. We've already read Oi Frog and Oi Dog, and this is the third book, Oi Cat. And it's by the same author and illustrator. So Kes Gray, the author, wrote the words, and Jim Field, the illustrator, drew these lovely pictures. And it's got some of the same characters that we've met before. So we've met the cat before, haven't we? And the frog. And there was one more person in this story that we've met before who's not on the cover. That's the dog. Now, the end papers in this one are all of the cat doing different things. Look, he's sleeping. He's having a stretch. He's being scared of a cucumber. Cats don't really like cucumbers very much. And, or peeking at a goldfish. All sorts of funny things. Okay. And look, here's the cat. He's got fly swatter squashing all these gnats. Oi, cat! Step away from the gnat, said the frog. Behind gnats, said the cat. Gnats are all nasty and nibbly, and they keep biting me on the bottom. And they are, look. Here's bottom. Covered in spots from the gnats biting him. Why do you keep sitting on them then? Asked the dog. Why don't you sit on a mat instead? Because the frogs change the rules, sighed the cat. Remember. That's right, said the frog. I've changed the rules. Dogs used to sit on frogs, but now they sit on logs. And cats used to sit on mats, but now they sit on gnats. And he looks rather smug and pleased with himself about that, doesn't he? It's a shame you're not a pony, said the dog. If you were a pony, you could sit on some macaroni. Just my luck, sighed the cat. Macaroni won't nibble your bottom, said the dog. Will you stop talking about my bottom, said the cat. My bottom is none of your business. Getting a bit grumpy, isn't he? To be honest though, I would be grumpy if something was nibbling me on the bottom.
If you were a chip, you could sit on a brick, smiled the frog. If you were a vole, you could sit in a bowl. If you were a leech, you could sit on a peach. And if you were a duck, you could sit on a truck.
Well, I'm not a chick, am I? Frowned the cat. Or a vole, or a leech, or a duck.
You're a cat, smiled the frog.
Oh, sorry, it's the dog that said that.
You're a cat, said the dog.
On a gnat, smiled the frog. And rules are rules.
Frog, bossy. He's enjoying that far too much, I think.
If you were an alpaca, you could sit on a cream cracker, said the dog.
If you were a mink, you could sit on a sink. If you were an armadillo, you could sit on a pillow. A lovely, comfy, soft pillow.
If you were a lark, you could sit on a shark, said the frog.
Unbelievable, said the cat.
If you were a shrimp, you could sit on a chimp, said the dog. If you were a bunny, you could sit on someone. If you were a pheasant, you could sit on a present. If you were a troll, you could sit on a doll.
Whatever he sits on, it has to rhyme with cat, said the frog.
Perhaps you could sit on a bat, said the dog.
Instead of a mat or a gnat, you could sit on a cricket bat, or a baseball bat, or a softball bat.
Bats sit on bats, bats, said the frog.
That's right, because you get two kinds of bats, don't you? The bats that fly and the bats that you play games with.
What if you were a kitty instead of a cat? Said the dog. If you were a kitty, you could sit on something pretty, like a pretty flamingo, or some sparkly boats, or some lovely, colourful streamers.
Dingoes sit on flamingos, crows sit on bows, and lemurs sit on streamers, said the frog.
How about a mug? Said the dog. If you were a mug, you could sit on a clog or a cog.
Hogs sit on clogs, said the frog, and cogs when there's a shortage of clogs.
Wait a moment, smiled the cat. If I was a mug, I could sit on a...
Step away from the frog.
Step away from the frog.
Sorry, it's a frog that said that. Frowned a frog.
Yes, no one can sit on a frog, nodded the dog. It has to be something that rhymes with frog. Or mug or cog or clog.
Said the cat.
What else rhymes with mug, frog, clog and cog?
Let me think.
Gog, jog, bog,
pog, rog, sog, tog, hog, vog, quog, zog.
Dog,
said the dog.
Dog rhymes with frog, mog, clog and cog.
So it does, smiled the cat.
So it does, clapped the frog.
And there's the frog sitting on his sun lounger and the dog saying, I wish I hadn't said that, said the dog. Because look, he's sitting on the dog, the cat. And I have to say, he isn't looking very pleased, is he? Oh dear. The cat's looking very pleased though. He thinks it's all very comfortable. Oh well. So there's one more book in this series and we'll read that next week. Okay. Well, I hope you enjoyed that and I'll see you again soon. Bye for now.